Hello guys, and welcome to Ring the Bell Restaurant. I am, of course, the main commentator, John Audubon, alongside Jason Todd.
Yes, it is great to be here for another jam-packed edition of Battlefront. We got a huge match to kick things off.
And number one to kick us off here tonight, coming out first, it is the boys.
The big matchup for the boys. Now, when, Swordo tag team around here in Ring the Bell. And you know, they've got a big match prepared for against some two guys who, of course, you know, once been this is a clutch, but this is the first time actually, you know, team together.
And the first time actually teaming together since, of course, leaving Georgia, but for now, though, the boys, they're going to be looking to try and take advantage of that here, using their experience against them here tonight. Of course, we know that the boys, they have been tag team champions for, the only ones that have ever beaten the Prestige. And now they're here tonight in this prestigious classic, and they're going to be looking to try and move forward in this one. And maybe to them, maybe get an easy win against a newly formed team.
Yeah, could be an easy win for the boys, but I'm not so sure it will be easy, you know. It's a neck down against this first time in teaming, but still be, you know, a tough matchup.
Well, coming out now, it's Jacob Weld and Rory Pierce.
Yep, this could be a very interesting dynamic, a very interesting match for these two as a tag team. Well, coming out as a tag team, of course, no longer, of course, you know, members of the clergy, they have gone away from that group and trying to make a name for themselves.
Try and make a name for themselves, and well, it's gonna start here tonight, and let's see if they are gonna be able to do just that here tonight in the prestigious classic tournament here. And well, I mean, we've already seen one team, an Apex and Battlefront teaming together, APH and Jonathan Reed, and they were able to succeed together. Maybe another newly formed team here can do well together in Rory and Jacob.
Very well, good. Just simply, Roy Pierce here, he's no stranger to tag team gold here in Ring the Bell. He's held it before, but you know, as of a different point, we'll see how him and Jacob's fair, well, you know, go together. Can it be a cohesive unit? Can they get the combined offense to put a major victory?
And can they step up here tonight? I mean, like you said, we've seen what Roy was able to do in tag team action. Jacob Wells, he used to be a long-reigning European champion, but now we're going to see here tonight who's going to be the better of the two teams here as well. Jacob Wells starting off here against Chase Hawkins.
Look at Chase Hawkins, look at that agility, hits his takedown, you're very quick.
Yeah, very quick here, but look at this, the big belly-to-belly suplex there by Chase, taking down Jacob Wells and trying to go for a quick cover here. No, only a one.
Just a one. As now, got the arm lock, but no. Jacob was able to escape.
Yeah, able to escape here, and look at this big Superman punch there by Chase Hawkins. Chase trying to continue there, but Jacob Wells able to roll out of the way. Now Jacob Wells has him, and a big slam there.
Yeah, huge type slam, and now as the arms, as the wrists are just stomping away.
Yeah, it's stomping away, but now Jacob going for the cover. Is this going to be enough? No, only a one.
Just a one and 12. Chase can't believe it. Shows such frustration. He's got to keep an offense. They play a little bit of possums now. Look at this big close fist punches.
Yeah, big close fist punches there by Jacob Wells. Jacob, now is the thing to do. Maybe he's going to get a quick tag in here. Get Rory Pierce now into the match. Now I think Chase is maybe trying to think of doing the same thing, but he's not going to be able to thanks to Rory Pierce.
Yeah, Rory Pierce able to quickly and easily cut him off. So look at this big combination.
Big combination there by Rory. Now Rory has him up. Big sweep of the legs, taking him down. But oh wait, spinning out of the way. And there's a big forearm strike there from Chase. And now it looks like Chase is going to get the Steel City Brawler, Georgie Mack, into the match. And yes, he is.
Maybe two, you know, little brawlers, striking professionals, specialists. Now get a kill out of it now, but you see Twitch Metal uses his palm and then hit a big punch.
Yeah, he had that big punch there, but now we're gonna still, again, using that power and just taking him down. And now what is Georgie Mac thinking of doing here? But we're able to get up here. Not able to hit it there, and there goes Georgie Mac. But no, Rory taking Georgie off his feet there.
He's sweeping away, gonna get Checkers back into the ring. Georgie Mac, quick on the exchange. But brings him down for a face buster.
Yeah, bring him down for a face buster there. But now what is Georgie Mac looking to do? Has him big punches here. There's, what a flare to it. And there's that big right arm.
Georgie Mac, you know, normally adding a little bit of flair to his striking. It's the boys in command right now.
Here's now cover two. No. Yeah, but now what is he looking into? But went trying to go for it there. Wasn't able to get him. But now Jacob throwing him. And oh, there goes Jeff the Ref.
Poor Jeff the Ref. Taking a fall there. He can't even recover quickly from it, though.
But oh, wait. And now just throwing him into the corner. Now what Jacob was looking to, but oh, wait. Able to turn around. Now gonna throw him into his own corner here. Maybe gonna tag Chase Hawkins in here. Yes, he does.
Got some double team offense in plan, but what are they thinking? Look at the agility there. Chase Hawkins, a big elbow drop, and then a splash from Georgie Mac.
Yeah, big splash there from Georgie Mac. But oh, wait. Rory wanting to tag. Chase Hawkins knocking him out. Chase gonna go for a cover. Not able to get him. They're only a one.
Just one. You see Chuck Ross immediately back on his feet. Oh, but can't be quicker on the exchange there. Now Chase Hawkins has him in the corner, but can take him into the other corner.
But, oh, there's that big boot there. But oh, is now Chase going for the cover here? No, wait. There he goes. And now one, two, no, only a two. Chase unable to get him.
Chase Hawkins showing that frustration. He's just keeping him in the offense because now Chuck Ross has caught him and got him in his corner. But no.
As always, now with a big suplex step. Oh my god, Chase Hawkins and made his way back up. Now turning over the arm, but no, Jacob Wells was able to stop him.
He is able to stop him there. And has now gotten in the corner. What's Jacob Wells got planned? No, Chase Hawkins, other ideas.
Yeah, it was all wait, trying to go for a big boot there. No, but now Chase Hawkins, what is he thinking of here? Has Jacob Wells up? No, has him taken down to slam him down. Georgie Mac, the powers of the team, but Chase Hawkins showing up power of his own.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, Chase Hawkins has got great agility, but he's got great power to him as well. And now whole Mitch Hanoku driver from Jacob Wells just suddenly found nowhere.
Yeah, big driver there from Jacob. Now Jacob has him up again onto the shoulders. Oh, big gut buster there.
Yeah, and then just drops all his weight down onto the body in a cover. But no, kick out from Chase Hawkins.
Yeah, big kick out there from Chase Hawkins. But now what is Jacob Wells looking to do? Big chop there. As always, has him DDT!
A brutal headlock driver. That could be it for Chase Hawkins, could be out of it from now.
He is now going for the cover. Is this going to be it? No, only a one.
Just a one. I mean, it's pretty brutal with that headlock driver, but not enough. Chase Hawkins has him now, has him up, and oh, goodness, drops him, you know, from the back of his neck.
Yeah, but look at this ankle hook here. Now taking him off his feet, and now again going after the ankle there. Not looking good there for Jacob Wells, but no way. Now we're going to get a tag in there to Georgie Mac. As always, Georgie, he's starting to feel it here. I think just waiting for Jacob Wells to get back up.
Yeah, just laying away, but I don't know, Georgie Mac, they think get on the offense, but no, just now picking up Jacob Wells.
As always, trying to go for a sweeper hold here. But no, instantly Jacob Wells is able to get out of it before he can fully punch it in.
Yeah, Jacob Wells, thankfully for him, was able to escape the hold. And now, Georgia Mac taking the fight to the outside.
Yeah, Georgia Mac able to take the fight to the outside here. Trying to go for a jumping crossbody, wasn't able to hit him. Now Jacob Wells throwing him back inside the ring. Those now, what does Jacob have in mind? Turning around, big suplex there, picking the big man off his feet.
Yeah, very impressive German suplex. And now, throwing Georgia Mac to the outside.
And throwing Georgia Mac to the outside. But now, though, what is Jacob going to do? But no, wait, big punch there to the midsection. So, going around, and now again, a big run around and a jumping crossbody there.
Huge toe crossbody. I mean, Georgia Mac showing it, you know. Yes, all that power by striker, but he can get agile when he needs to.
Mm-hmm, but now Georgia Mac has Jacob Wells up here. Big running bulldog taking him off his feet, you know. Georgia Mac certainly feeling it on the outside, but we're up to a six count here. Needs to get back inside the ring. Big strikes there again to Jacob Wells. Georgie trying to continue here. No way, both men not able to land. Up to an 8 count here. Georgia Mac going to make his way inside the ring. Could Jacob Wells get back in? Up to a 9. Is Georgia going to take it? No, he's not.
Last split second changed his mind.
Yeah, changed his mind here. But oh, big strikes there from Georgia Mac. It's now just continuing here. And now throwing him back inside the ring. What is Georgia Mac going to do now?
Whatever he had planned could backfire as Jake Ross is able to tag Roy Pierce, but no, oh! I thought Georgia Mac had Roy Pierce there, but no, hits big counter. And oh, spiking DDT!
Yeah, big spiking DDT. Now what is Roy looking to do? Going for the cover, is this going to be it? 2, no!
Roy Pierce could not believe it. He thought he had Georgia Mac finished for there. And now Georgia Mac to take advantage.
Yeah, we're going to try to take advantage. Big strikes here from Roy Pierce. But no, wait, Jacob. Sorry. Georgia Mac able to start fighting back here. And oh, and take him down. Big brainbuster there. Is now, what is Georgia Mac looking to do? Is now throwing him into the corner. Maybe going to get tagged in here. No, he's going to turn Roy Pierce around. Has something in mind here.
Man, that's something in mind, but what in the world is it?
Georgie has him, and big avalanche suplex there. Big German suplex there from Georgie Mac. As now has him up again as a big strike to Roy Pierce.
And it's punching him right in the jaw after popping him up. And now gut wrench suplex from Georgie Mac. You know, Roy Pierce is struggling right now.
Big one right there. So, oh, wait. Now turning around. Going for the cover. Can he put him away here? No, only a 1.
It's just a 1 count. Roy Pierce, he's still got a lot of fight in him. Still could go.
As now, though, Georgie has him. And, oh, taking him down into the cover. Is this going to be it? 2. No, Roy kicks out.
Yeah, Roy kicks out from that rage bomb there. I thought that was going to be it, though. But no, Roy Bishop, he's got a lot of tenacity in him.
Yes, now look at this, though. Roy has him. Big slam in there. Now trying to go for some of that. But oh, wait. Big kicks there from Georgia Mac. Is now Georgia Mac. Big senton.
A huge senton. Just throwing all his body weight onto Roy Pierce, just kicking at the back.
As now has him, big fireman's carry. As oh, it's now big DDT there. Now what is Roy we're gonna do? Maybe gonna go for the cover here.
Maybe Sammy thinks it's over yet. Go for the cover.
2, no.
Not to be. What's Roy Pierce just can't believe it. And both these teams, I think I'll be exhausted to quench her for help. But look out of nowhere. That can
cover. No, only a one.
Good lord, just a one count.
Yeah, but now taking him down. Now what is Rory looking to do? Dropping down to double knees.
Dropping his knees down, but now well towards the belt, but don't say how smart that is. He's got to continue on the offense.
Yeah, trying to continue on the offense here. Rory has Georgie Mack here, but right in front of Chase Hawkins. Trying to go for it. Has him up.
He certainly has him up and brings him down.
Into the cover. Two, but no, right in front of Chase Hawkins. But now Jacob Blow is going to take care of Chase Hawkins here. Perfect time for Roy, but right now Georgie Mack on top.
Yeah, Georgie was able to quickly turn that round. But Roy Pierce, oh no, I thought he was going to catch him. Georgie right there, but no, big pack suplex.
Big back suplex there, but now Georgie Mack has him. But oh, look at that, big strike there. Oh, wait. Roy trying to put him away. Big running bulldog. But now Georgie trying to take him down there. Big knockout strike. But oh, it's now once again showing out the power is Georgie Mack has him. Gut wrench suplex there.
So showing up power once again, and now cover hook off the leg as he got him here.
Two, no.
Not over. Georgie Mack just can't believe it. Well, see Chase Hawkins take it out. Check Rose, but not definitely fully. It's a big German suplex being hit.
Yeah, big German suplex, but now big chops there from Rory. But all power struggle here, and Georgie Mack gonna win it there, trying to go for a slam there, but wasn't able to get him. It's now Jacob being told to leave, just barely able to make it. And now being thrown into the corner. Maybe gonna get Chase Hawkins in, but no wait. Gonna get some running power into that big slam there.
Got all that power now.
And now Jacob wanted to get a tag in. Yes, he does. Jacob holds his in. But no, Georgie Mack doesn't care.
He doesn't. I thought Georgie Mack may have been making a mistake, but Jacob was in, but no, he calculated that perfectly, knew exactly what to do.
Yeah, I mean, Georgie Mack, he faith going in high, but he went low, but look at that big DDT!
And no one has headlock drivers, could that be it?
Cover! Two! No! Chase breaks it up! But now, what is Jacob Wells saying I'm doing here? Wells is now taking him down. Now Jacob Wells trying to put him away once and for all.
You're looking to. Can he? Has him up. Uh-oh.
It's
Oh, the God style punch, brother. That could be its cover.
Cover. Two. Three. And Jacob Wells and Roy Pierce pick up the victory.
Well, it's a great first victory for them as a team. And yeah, amazing to see. Seems that they have found, well, how to be a success.
Yeah, they definitely found out how to be a success. And they had the stamina to go against the boys. Big victory there for Jacob Wells and Rory Pierce. We're going to be moving on now to women's action here. Big triple threat. Brooke Reed, Naomi Jordan, Nikita B. Coming up next.
Yeah, great women's action here. Got to think, this has got, you know, some women's title rankings in mind.
Yeah, definitely going to indeed. As coming out first, it is Naomi Jordan.
Yeah, let's see if it could be Naomi Jordan who could be the one to pick up the victory. Yeah, move ahead in the women's division rankings here on Battlefront. So currently, well, the women's championship here with Battlefront held by Kelly Casey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, recently the titles have been put on both brands. Kelly Casey, of course, is the Battlefront women's champion, and these three women definitely going to be looking to try and move up the rankings, get in front of Mikey Lee's eyes here, of course, the interim GM, and try and make their way into, you know, the top contention for that title.
Yep, it's again to that top contender spot. The victory here certainly gets a step closer, so can Naylor Jordan be the one who picks up that victory, gets a step closer?
Mm-hmm. Well, Naylor Jordan's certainly looking ready here. But now coming down to the ring, it is Brooke.
You know, Brooke will be able to try to save to, you know, score the big victory, put her name forward, and to, you know, attempt a total contention. See, all three of the women in this are all hungry and determined. Well, she's gonna look to, you know, show that she's, you know, top contender around here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, she will be looking to do just that. We've seen what Brooke has been able to do in the past. And she's going to be looking to try and prove that more here tonight. Try and get a big win here. Try and get maybe even two eliminations here. Of course, it is an elimination match here. And see if Brooke's going to be able to do just that. Get, like we said, catch the eye of Mikey Lee. And maybe try and get into a number one contendership match. But coming out next, it is Nikita B.
Yep, the final woman in this match is Nikita B. You know, she is no stranger to, you know, championship cold, you know, title contention. You know, she's held the women's tag team titles before. So, you know, she'd love to get an opportunity to go after the Battlefront Women's Championship. I hope that too.
Yeah, she definitely will indeed, of course. I mean, we've only had two women hold both the tag and a women's title. Of course, that was Brittany Blake and Katie Bisping now. But we're going to see if maybe, if Nikita didn't get a big win here tonight, get a big win in a number contention match, maybe we'd be trying to join those rankings there.
But since she's going to deal with, you know, two other women who just are equally as hungry, try to get to total contention, so see it gets a big win. As you can see, Brooke going straight after and Jordan in after Nikita.
Yeah, joining in there is now the big knees there, but oh wait, has her up. Big hurricane runner there from Naylor Jordan. Now Naylor with a drop kick there.
Huge time drop kick, and now checking Nikita around. It's, oh, misses the attempted moonsaults.
Yeah, but oh wait, now what is she looking to do here? Brooke has her, but no wait. Big punch into the midsection there from Nikita. Now Nikita has her up here. Big net breaker and a suplex there.
Impressive combinations that go for a cover. No.
But now, wait, has her here. Big abdominal stretch.
Got it locked in. For Brooke, yep, she is able to escape his head scissors takedown.
Yeah, big head scissors takedown. Oh, wait, big chop there. But now, wait, Brooke has to get it here. And oh, we got big knee there.
Huge knee strike. Brooke has been very impressive in this match, just firing on all cylinders. The only problem with that could be is if she wears herself out too soon, it's like go for a cover. An easy kick out from Nikita.
Yeah, but now though, big strikes there from Brooke. Has her not gonna be able to get her. Big kicks there.
And brutal super kick right to the back of the head. Now look at this. Kick in the hamstring area of Nikita, it takes it down.
Yeah, but now what's Naylor Jordan looking to do? Big kicks there, and now it just has her locked in here.
Just torturing the body there. Yes. And now.
But now Naylor telling Brooke to get up here. But now what does she have in mind? Big elbow strike there. Has Brooke up.
Has her up. Now what? Let's drop her into the ropes.
Big stun gun there. Now Nikita, what is she looking to do? And there's a big suplex there. And now, cover, but no, not enough.
We've got one count there. My Georgia, she's still got plenty of fight in her. It's now, oh, tried for a tornado kick. And the kid got away a little bit.
It's not now cover. Two, no, not enough.
Yep. Hey, Jordan's still alive in this one. Now.
Oh, it's now we're sure we can go for it here. Bam! Moonsault there from Nikita.
Yeah, very impressive. It's now picking up Ayla Jordan and neckbreaker and double underhook suplex.
Hey, would have hit it there. Nikita trying to go at the brick, but look at this though. Able to catch her. Two! No!
He was able to kick out though, but that was great ring awareness from Brooke to, you know, notice he was there quick to roll her up, but gets kicked down with the head scissors.
Mm-hmm. But now though, Nikita trying to go after Brooke there, only on one count. Now, what is Nikita thinking? What does she need to do to put away Brooke here? Nikita though, taking down Brooke again, and another big kick as Nayla Jordan re-entering the ring.
Back in, it's now Brooke, a big elbow strike, and now Jordan going after the kick, after Nikita, and hit a DDT!
Big DDT there, but oh, it's now Brooke has her up here, big shot there, now has a Rainmaker!
Huge Rainmaker!
Cover! Two, no! Yeah, but now Nayla has her up here, not able to get it up, but taken down, and Brooke going for the cover. Can this be it? Two! No!
Alright, Jordan's able to survive, because now Nikita has Brooke.
As always, now what does Nikita have in mind? Trying to take her to the corner, but no, wait, Brooke able to fight her way out of it.
Yeah, whoever Nikita had plans, Brooke was not going to let it happen.
Yeah, but wait, going for a big kick there. Wasn't able to get her. Now Nikita has her, and a big Russian leg sweep.
Yeah, very impressive. Brooke doing the small fish here. She's rolled outside trying to get a breather. As long as Nikita takes down Nayla Jordan, go for cover.
Two, three, and Nayla Jordan has been eliminated.
Yep. And well, Nikita catch and continue on. It was Brooke done the really smart thing. She rolled to the outside. Or did she not get enough of a breather? Oh, wait, she's fighting back.
Yeah, she's fighting back. Nikita was trying to continue the momentum, but wasn't able to. But now, look at this though, Brooke throwing her around. What does she have in mind now?
What has she got planned?
But oh wait, Brooke throwing her back inside. As now what does Brooke have in mind? Has her up here. Trying to take her down. No wait, roll through. And a big kick!
Nasty kick. Now just smashing the back of the head into the ring mat.
Yeah, but now what does Brooke have in mind here? She's just waiting for Nikita to get back up here.
Is she taking too much time?
Is she taking too much time? Waiting for her. Trying to go for her here. Rainmaker again!
Rainmaker! Could this be as Brooke picked up a huge victory?
Two! No!
God, Nikita able to kick out.
Yeah, but... No, wait! Big cutter! Now, could this be it? Two! No! Not enough to put away Nikita.
And Kish trying absolute fire and decides to get the victory here. Gets coined to a flatliner.
Yeah, but now, what is Brooke looking to do? Has Nikita up here. Big strike there. Never clothesline. And a drop kick there. As... I'm being told that Norman Gorman is leaving us here from the table, but look at this big Rainmaker!
Huge Rainmaker! No one's leaving, but
two, three, and Brooke able to pick up the victory.
Yeah, Brooke picks up a huge victory. Wait, Norman, if you go backstage, now get I got some Skittles. No.
I think he's got something else in mind. But for now, Brooke, big victory here. And definitely going to be moving herself up the rankings here after a big victory here tonight. But now, being told, we're going backstage here. Oh, Mikey back here saying, hello, Norman. Glad you're able to make it. I understand you're trying to be a reporter. Well, I'm glad to be the first person to interview. So please ask away.
Good to see that Norman, you know, he's wearing a face covering. Doesn't wear one on the commentary table, but yeah, he's wearing one there.
Maybe Mikey asked him to do that. And Norman said, yes, of course, that would be a great interviewer. Just let me look at my notes my dad wrote. Yes. You are the new GM while Dom is away. Is there anyone you see potential in as a chosen one when Dom sees in John Freed? Yep, that's the question.
I think you need to do that voice actor better. I think it's more like this. Yes, of course, because of, you know, the face covering.
Could very well be indeed, but well, definitely asking big questions there. Is Norman, even if his dad wrote the notes there for him?
But, I mean, that's what gave the chosen one.
Well, Mikey's saying, don't be so nervous, Norman, but of course I see many great talents that Dom has looked over, and some he's so very much prestigiously overrated. But I do see big potential in someone, but they'll need to make a big impact for it. Consider him for any major plans going forward before Dom's eventually untimely return to Battlefront.
Well, God, you know, who Mikey sees? Who has he got in mind?
And who does he have in mind?
It'll be himself.
But no one's saying, oh, yes, of course, because Dom returning will be a bad thing. Anyway, who is this? Anyway, this is all the TV time my dad will allow me to do, so thank you all for watching. Wait, what does this say? Oh, of course, the show name. Well, guys, it's been a quick but fun time here. See you guys next time for another Gore Minute.
A Gore Minute? Okay, that's a new thing we got going then.
Well, you know, Norman Gorman, you know, his dad's giving some TV time.
Giving him some TV time? Well, we'll wait till he gets back before we can give him our opinions.
I'm sure he would love their opinions. I'm sure, you know, he was a great interviewer, though. Let's continue here as Aaron Wyatt going to be going 1-on-1 against Jonathan Reed.
Well, some great singles action here. We'll see in this one who can get the big time victory.
And who will get the big time victory is coming down to the ring now. It is Aaron Wyatt.
Yep, let's see if it's going to be Aaron Wyatt who can pick up the big time victory tonight. So, you know, try and bounce back from, you know, disappointment of what happened. You know, Anderson Survivor, who had the betrayal he felt. And see if he can pick up a big time win here tonight.
And let's see if Aaron Wyatt can be able to do just that. I mean, we already heard, you know, from the interim GM saying that he's looking to try and get people, see people impressive here. And well, one definite thing I could see being impressive is beating, you know, Dom's Chosen One, especially since Dom's Chosen One was able to beat the Prestige by himself in tag action.
Yeah, it was very impressive, and yes, there must be a thing of how he won, you know, it was a count-out victory. But at the same time, you know, his back was against the wall, you know. He was in, you know, a handicapped situation, and, you know, he just used a perfect tactic. He beat the Prestige sheet away at their own game, and you could question his methods, the way he went about it, but at the same time, you know, a win's a win.
A win is definitely a win, and well, one man definitely looking to try and get a big win here tonight is going to be Aaron Wyatt, and let's see if he's going to be able to do just that here. I mean, he's going to be going against a very tough opponent, going against Dom's Chosen One, and we're going to see if he's going to be able to do that here tonight.
Yep,
yeah,
it's a fantastic night, so we can't pick a big time victory.
Speaking of, coming down to the ring now, even though Dom's not here, he is still Dom's Chosen One, Jonathan Reed.
Yep, still Dom's Chosen One, you know, can you question him, you know, Jonathan Reed is really, I feel like, proving himself. I think he's even possibly proving himself a little bit to Mikey Lee. Maybe Mikey Lee does see a little bit of and what dogs all on a ballot because this player's chosen one. Now, tonight's another big test. I feel an opportunity for Jonathan Reed.
Yeah, big test here for Jonathan Reed. I mean, we've seen what Jonathan Reed's been able to do, especially while Dom was here, while he was Dom's chosen one. But even while Dom's been away, he's been excelling, like we said, getting a big victory in a handicap match. Yes, it was, of course, by countout, but in the end, a handicap match, I think it's really your best match to go for.
Yep, it was really the best tactic to go for. It worked out for Jonathan Reed. Now he picked up a victory as a result.
Mm-hmm. But now we're about to get started here. Jason, who do you have in this one?
I'm gonna go with Jonathan Reed this one. You know, he's got a lot to point, you know, prove. He's got a point to prove, and I don't know if Aaron Watts could be fully recovered, you know, still maybe from what happened at Soul Survivor, how that could be affecting him mentally.
Yeah, it could very well be indeed. I mean, getting attacked by a man that he thought was his tag partner, but now he's going to have to try and move past that here tonight. He's had some time off, and now he's here, and he's going to try and move past that here tonight, getting a big win against Jonathan Reed. Jonathan, though, has Aaron Wyatt up here in a big power driver.
It's power driven. Oh, wait. Norman, you're back. Where's my Skittles?
I'm pretty sure he told you no.
You know, Norman, that interview, your performance, it was shit.
I
said it.
You can't talk about the boss's son like that. I think it was a great interview.
He didn't give me my Skittles.
Yeah, but I mean, how was he going to give you Skittles when he was trying to be, you know, a professional interviewer, you know?
And after the interview, I mean, he took his sweet time getting back here.
I don't think he did, but right now, though, Aaron Wyatt working over here against Jonathan Reed's arm here, has him up in a big side slam there.
Whatever, I'll just move on from this. Because now, Aaron Wyatt has the advantage.
And look at that big shining wizard there.
Watch hitting it all. A tornado insecurity, but Jonathan Reed has him.
But look at that power there from Jonathan Reed. But even after that, Aaron Ryan was still able to push that kick away. And now a big knee there. As now just big stomps. Now what is Aaron Ryan looking to do? Has him. But no, wait, Jonathan Reed pushing him off.
I'm sure if he's this feet strip and then hitting a sling blade.
Yeah, but now what is Aaron Wyatt looking to do? He's all wait, now being thrown to the outside. But Jonathan Reed, what is he doing there? Is now Aaron Wyatt just able to take advantage, throwing him into the corner? Aaron Wyatt has something in mind here, has him up.
Is it not the words he got planned here? Something big from the top. Wait, oh my, no way.
As look at the Spanish fly off the top!
The huge, huge Spanish fly. Run caution to the wind.
Yeah, caution to the wind. Driving that knee into the back. As now Aaron has him up here. So wait. Taking down a big slam there from Aaron Wyatt. Is now working over on the arms here. Aaron Wyatt has him up here. Another big side slam there from Aaron Wyatt. Aaron Wyatt has him up again. Aaron Wyatt has been relentless here. Now Jonathan Reed able to get some breathing room here.
Yeah, but now making a big mistake though. He gets all hung up with that neck breaker.
Yeah, big neck breaker there is now Aaron Wyatt. Maybe thinking of going up high. No weight, going to the corner. And a big knee into the side of the head.
Right to the side. That could have knocked Jonathan Reed out. Could be a big time victory for him once he goes out of cover.
Two. No.
Not able to get it.
Not able to get it. John Furrier going to the outside. Thinking, what is he doing? As Aaron Wyatt has been in control of this matchup for the most part here. But Aaron Wyatt not going to allow him to set the pace of the match there. But wait, a sling by the net from Jonathan Reed.
And have a sling glide, and now Aaron Wyatt's in trouble. He's using a ropes to get up. Just pulling himself up as Joffrey can try to take advantage.
Yeah, trying to take advantage here. Throwing him off here. But look at this agility from Jonathan Reed.
Yeah, very impressed with that handspring cutter. That could be it for Aaron Wyatt. He's going for a cover.
There's no one at one.
Just on one guy. Aaron Wyatt able to kick out.
Able to kick out here. Now John Farid has Aaron Wyatt up. But oh, GTS! Into the cover. No one at one.
Just the one count. But Joffrey can't believe it.
Yeah, can't believe it here. But look at this though, John Farid has him up. Into the gutbuster there. Aaron Wyatt rolling to the outside.
Yeah, smart decision there to roll that, try to get away. So Joffrey can't try to maybe capsize off a pitfall. So now look at this, Aaron Wyatt catches him. It's another neck breaker.
Huge neck breaker there. Now Aaron Wyatt has John Farid up. What is he looking to do? Big knee there. And taken down. Now into the cover. Two, three, and Aaron Wyatt picks up the victory.
Wow, impressive victory for Aaron Wyatt. I think Mikey Lee will be looking at Aaron Wyatt as a chosen one.
And it could very well be indeed. Big win there from Aaron Wyatt over John Farid, over Dom's chosen one there.
Yeah. And the Dom's chosen one, a very impressive victory for Aaron Wyatt.
Yeah, big victory there. Well, let's see what Aaron Wyatt's future may hold there. Big win. We're going to be moving on in now to women's action here as Tony Six going to be going 1-on-1 against Louise Bates.
Yep. Well, two tactics specialists, you know, going out in 1-on-1 action. Let's see who's going to get the big win.
Let's see who's going to get the big win here. Coming out first, representing Ghost Myself, it is Tony Six.
And one half of the women's tag team champions, Tony Six here, and accompanied by Katie Brisbane, as Ghost Myself. We'll see it out in sequels competition if Tony Six can pick up a big time victory here tonight.
Let's see if they can get a big time victory here tonight. For now though, Katie Brisbane going to be supporting Tony here on the outside. Let's see if Tony can't get a big victory over against this tag team. Against Lou, who of course their tag team beat HBIC last week, and they could very well be moving to number one contenders here, of course, for the Battlefront side, especially if they beat Tony 6-8 tonight.
Oh yeah, definitely. If we help him building towards here again, a Battlefront number one contendership.
Well, coming now down to the ring, it is the Vibe Station.
Yep. And so Louise Bates will be representing the Vibe Station. Because the Vibe Station, you know, they are former women's tag team champions, so they want to try and capture that glory at some point. You know, Louise Bates, if she can capture victory against one half of the current champions, and puts the Vibe Station in that step closer to try and go in after those titles once again.
Yeah, it could very well indeed. I mean, we've seen what, like you said, we've seen what the Vibe Station have been able to do. Granted, when they first got the tag titles, it was because Small and Smaller broke up, Violet Edwards left, and the title was handed to Jordynne Payne, and they weren't able to defend it. But right now, they're going to be looking to try and, you know, bounce back, get back into title contention and get a big win. Well, as we get this match underway here, Jason, who do you have in this one?
No. I'm gonna have to sit. Yeah, I'm gonna go We've tried success right now. Armando and Apex, Ghost itself suffered a tough defeat. So I want to try and bounce back from that. Tell you all, want to try and bounce back from that by scoring a major victory here in this singles competition.
And they're going to be looking to do just that. I mean, we've seen what Ghost and Self has been able to do in the past, but they did suffer a big loss before. Now they're going to try and bounce back here. But you got to be thinking, though, here with Louise Bates, I mean, she's got to be riding momentum here, just beating HBIC last week, you know, former tag team champions, and now they're going against, you know, one half of the tag team champions who are, seems to be after last week, or after Monday, in a bit of a slump.
Yeah, a little bit, but you know, so I guess herself, and in this case, Tercy, she'll be, you know, looking to try and bounce back from that, you know, pick up a major victory, get the confidence back, you know, for Ghost herself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but wait, trying to go for her there, wasn't able to get her, saying no, no, and now, big DDT! As now, trying to work over here, twisting of the neck there.
We're seeing Regen in the head and neck area, trying to cause pain to suffering is now. It's a big drop kick.
Yeah, big drop kick there is now. What is Tony looking to do? Tony going up high.
Yeah, what is she got planned? Turn around.
Oh my goodness.
Beautiful moonsault. You showed great agility as the cover. No, this place kicking out.
Yeah, Ruby's able to kick out there. It's now, what is she looking to do? Throwing her into the corner.
You're going in that corner. What's her respect? Got planned. I'll just smash the head into that turnbuckle.
Yeah, but now, who is Bates turning around? Now, what's she going to do? Trying to go for a cover. Is this going to be it? No, not even a one.
Yeah, not even a one count. Well, he's basically a cover. I believe it, but I mean, I can't expect that that's going to happen. And it's missing that clothesline attempt.
Yeah, missing it there. But now Tony has her up. An electric chair there from Tony Six. Now Tony Quick and trying to continue here against Lou. But no, a big slap there from Louise Bates. Yeah, but now what is Lou looking to do? Trying to continue here against Tony Six here. Has her up. Has her. And a big face buster there. Now Louise Bates trying to go for a big pinning opportunity here. Can she put her away? One, no, no, only a one there.
Just looking a kick to the back.
A big kick to the back is now Louise trying to continue here. Big strikes there from Louise Bates. Now trying to put Tony back into the middle of the ring here. Maybe gonna go for a cover here. No, gonna go after the leg here of Tony.
Yeah, but Tessic's keeping up. It actually caught Louise Bates. Because now has a big neck breaker.
Yeah, bend neck breaker there. Now, what is Tony looking to do?
He's dropping the knee down on the face.
There's all weight and a big drop kick there. Now what's she looking to do? Tony going for the cover. This is going to be it. No, only a one.
Yeah, just a one count.
There's all weight. Lou trying to go for a big boot there. Wasn't able to get her. But now look at this Canadian Destroyer.
A huge Canadian Destroyer. That could be it. Louise Bates could be out of it.
And Louise could be out of it here. Tony going for the cover. This is going to be it. No, we are one. But now, Tony, we're gonna maybe try and put her away once and for all here.
Yeah, look at two. Can she bend over? Louise Bates counters with a 2-6 had planned.
Yeah, big fireman scared her. But now, Wu has her up here. And go for another gory bomb there.
It's well, 2-6 is in trouble. Louise Bates kick into the stomach.
Because she was trying to go for it again. No, it hasn't. That's a big powerbomb there.
Just rubbing it down with a brutal powerbomb. Now the way Spence taking Tony into the center. Grab for the cover, hooking the leg.
Yeah, cover. No, only a one. But now, what is Tony Sis looking to? Trying to go for a dropkick. Wasn't able to hit her. Now Louise Bates has her up. And just driving the head into the canvas.
And driving it down headlock. Driving, that could be it.
Now one, two. No, Tony kicks out.
And Tony Sis able to kick out. Louise Bates can't quite believe it. She's just got to keep on the offense. She's just got to think of what to do next. It's a big clothesline.
Yeah, the big clothes on here. It's just taken down. As always now, Louise Bates has her up here again. And so a big Russian leg sweep.
Big timing now. Picking out Tony Six. What's she got planned next? Well, Tony Six counter, a big kick into the stomach. Now hitting a clothesline of her own.
Now hitting a huge clothesline. Now going for the cover. No, yeah, two.
And just a two count series. Bates getting out behind her.
As always, big shot there from Tony. As always, now what is Tony thinking about doing? As now has her up here, running through. And another clothesline. As always, trying to go for it there. But no, he gets hit with a super kick instead. As now as Tony looking to trying to threaten her here, pushing her against the ropes there. But now big kicks there from Louise Bates. Now Lou throwing her off the ropes. Has her into a backbreaker.
And a big total backbreaker now covered hook in the leg, but no, Tony Six able to kick out.
Now as big punch into the back. Tony, we're going to try and continue. Has her up here. Another big backbreaker there.
Yeah, that suplex backbreaker. She's put away a pose with that before. And now go for a cover.
Cover. Two. No, only a two.
Oh,
was trying to go for a big boot there. Wasn't able to hit her. But now Tony hit a boot of her own. But now has her against the ropes. Big kicks to the back. Now Lou throwing her. Oh, this doesn't look good. There's a big drop kick there.
Big timing now. Got to cover, hooking the leg.
And one, two. No, only a two. As always now, trying to threaten her. Not able to. And just a big push off there from Tony Six. Tony not able to get her. Now being thrown into the corner. Now what does Lou have in mind? Just stretching the boot into the face of Tony Six.
She's trying to choke the life out of her. And now, again.
Again, just laying on that big boot there. Now what does Louise have in mind? Just throwing her over the ropes. And now, Lou going to the outside, starting to celebrate here a little too early.
Yeah, a little too early. Can't be celebrating too early. Could cost her, but now, just stomping at the stomach.
Yeah, stomping at the stomach. Now, what is Louise Bates looking to? Has Tony Six up here, but no, Tony. Big orange jack here. But now Lou's starting to fight back. But Tony able to throw her back inside the ring at a five count there. Now what is Tony looking to do? Has Lou up. Went for a jump kick, but it's just pushed to the side.
And look at that big combination of strikes and it. Whoa! Okay.
I mean, we're not over there, but come on, Lou.
Yeah, I don't know why she had that, who was really targeted at.
Yeah, holograms out there, but I mean, they are growing more sentient every day, but cover. Two.
No.
Maybe someone said something about her eye patch.
Oh, maybe. Maybe one of our, you know, one of them went, "Yarr, matey." She didn't like it.
Yeah, maybe not. Maybe someone said one eyed Lou, but not a big fan. But now, throwing her off the ropes here. Wait. Look at this.
Oh, big this.
Hunter.
Yeah.
Lou go for cover. Two. No. But now, Louise must be thinking, what does she need to do to put away Tony Six once and for all here? As all now has her up. And just has her here.
That gory special just looked dead. Can't Tony find an escape to this? Might as well release this. The whole baby was loose on it.
Yeah, it may very well be indeed. As now, what is Lou looking to do? Just trying to continue here against Tony. Now has her up. So is now Lou has her. And what is she trying to go for it again? But no, a gory bomb this time.
That drops up face first. And now, oh, kick into the chest and another one. And then, oh, right into the face.
Yeah, right into the face. Now Lou has her up here. And a big suplex. But now a big stomp there from Louise Bates. Now what is she looking to do? Has her up here.
Has her up now and drops her with that flapjack face buster. And that's dragging Louise Bates more towards the center, go for a cover.
Two, no.
No, not over.
Yes, now what she will do, taking her down, a big kick to the back. And now Tony trying to continue. And now into a domino stretch here, maybe. Now look at this!
Yeah, grab the leg. Just causing more pain and suffering that domino stretch. She get a tap out. No, Louise Bates escapes.
Now Lou able to escape here, but now Lou has Tony up here. Big boot into the midsection. Lou has her up. And a big jumping power bomb there. And into the cover.
And now,
two. No. Tony able to kick out.
Yeah, able to. Louise Bates now picking her back up. Just gonna think of something else, maybe. Oh, maybe go for a slap, but now Tony catches her, pushes her away.
Yeah, but look at this though. Dropping her onto the knee and just continuing there. Just driving the knee into the back.
Yeah, just torturing the body and now. Caught up. This 2-6 got planned, just has the boot. Domino stomach.
Yeah, but now what is Tony we're gonna do? Has her up here. Oh, that
sunset
there.
It's that. That could be it. Can always be taken out by that.
Two. No.
I cannot believe it. Both these women have given it their all. Could be the one who picks up the victory. Louise Pace has turned it and drops her a jawbreaker.
Yeah, but now Lou taking back control here, has up here, big kicks here, and another one. And the third one to take her off her feet.
Yeah, right into the face. Turned out rolling to the outside, just try to catch a breather. Well, he's basically looks like she's waiting, not looking to follow her.
Now throwing her into the corner. What is she looking to do? But no, a big boot there. And a chop block.
Yeah, big time chop block. That guy for a cover.
Two. No. As now What is she looking at too? Big snap suplex there.
Top snap suplex of it. Don't Louis Bates did again, flipping off the fans.
Someone else is saying something to her there. But oh wait, baseball slide that. Big Hurricane Rana.
Lovely to Hurricane Rana. And now Louis Bates. Oh, a sent up to herself a big air wish you could plant.
As oh wait, trying to go far there, but not able to get her.
No, not able to, but not able to capitalize. It's now back suplex. Now cover, look at the leg.
Two, no. As now, what is Tony looking to do? Big clap there from Lou, but now Lou driving the knee into the back. Now Lou has her up here. What is she looking to do? But no way, Tony able to fight back. Big boot there. And look at that big elbow. Now Tony looking to go up high. Is this going to be it?
Yeah, she's up top. What has she got planned? Oh, another moonsault maybe.
It's hits it. But oh, not going to go for the pin. We're going to try to continue here against Lou.
Yeah, look at two.
Oh, has her up. Sunshine there. Now she might be thinking of going for a cover.
Yeah, maybe some. Could this be it?
There's one, two, three.
And wow, 2-6, an impressive victory tonight. It was hard fought, but those two women gave it their all. 2-6 is the better woman here tonight.
Yeah, 2-6 with the better woman here tonight. Able to get a big win here against Louise Bates. Whoa. When you said they were able to bounce back from their loss on Apex, now big win here in the singles department here from 2-6.
Yeah, big top singles win.
Yeah, but now we're going backstage here. Justin Stone talking to Dustin, saying, Dustin, I know you've been avoiding me, but I forgive you for attacking me last week for my shot at the EU title, but you are a better man than this. I know you are. I've seen better during the good days at the compound, but now you've abandoned your ways. I heard you sold your car, choosing to skate everywhere. Come back home, Dustin.
No, Dustin, don't listen to him. You're another one who broke free of this.
I mean, he sold his car. Like, what sensible decisions is he making?
Sometimes, you know, he cares about the environment.
Well, Dustin's saying, well, chill, Justice. I know we may think it was good days, but they weren't now that I've been coasting place to place, skating around. I never felt so free. I know courage was all by free will, so please, Justice, I'm asking this to be my friend and not my priest. Let me go and be free and tell the old one to get past his midlife crisis.
Thank you, Dustin. See, yeah, the clergy preaches about free will, but as soon as people, you know, break free of the group, the old boy can't take it. Yeah, he's a midlife crisis.
Well, Justin's saying, come on, Dustin. You both know I can't do that. It hasn't been the same since Rory left us. We need to band together now more than ever. And Joe has been going through a midlife crisis. He's been grieving the loss of Brandon, Rory, and most importantly, Jacob. He can't take you as well. The compound is so big to be so lonely.
Dustin's doing a right thing. You know, the other members who have left, they realized how messed up that place was. They didn't have free will.
They saved themselves.
Just
saying, Justice, how about this? A state of emergency, you and me, 1v1, leave Joe at home, and let's fight this out like old time's sakes. We were always close to the compound, and I've learned the most from you. So one last time, with fight in the middle ring, if I was, I'll walk from ring to bell wrestling, but if I win, we'll fix Joe Blade together.
Justin, you know what? You can do the right thing, Steve, but you just lay down. Take the pin, and you two.
And you want him to leave?
Stop Joe Blade.
But you want him to leave in the bell?
No, it's Dustin Weaver. If he wins, they go off with Joe Blade together. As I said, Justice Stone lay down.
Yeah. So you want him to go back in the clergy? That's great. You want Drago versus Zach Wood. Part of the EU tournament.
Destroy Joe Blade.
No, the fix. Fix him.
No, to destroy Joe Blade in disturbing ways.
Well, All of that being said, though, coming down to the ring now, it is Eli Drago.
Yep, well, Eli Drago, of course, he was part of the Apex roster, but now part of the Battlefront roster after where he decided he had had enough of Coach Morgan and, you know, decided he would have, you know, be at the side of Coach Morgan and decided to come over to Battlefront and try to make a move in the European title tournament.
And he's going to be making, staking his claim here in the European title tournament. We saw what Eli Drago was able to do on Apex. He demanded a trade from Coach. He's now gotten his trade. He is here on Battlefront, and he is a part of the European title tournament, but he's going against a man who has just recently signed in Zach Quinn. He doesn't have anything on him to really know what he is like, but Eli Drago is going to take the risk here tonight. He took the risk leaving Apex. He said he would go to Battlefront and he will flourish and he will become a champion because no one of the Coach Morgan boys were able to do that.
Yeah, well, let's see if he'd be able to live up to that. And since, you know, Alex Burnham, she would have been able to do a little bit of homework on Zachary Quinn, you know, it's a dependent base, you know. I've seen what Zachary Quinn is capable of. And I've seen the short things he's done, and, you know, he's an impressive individual. So we'll see how this match fares tonight.
And then we're going to see how he fares here tonight as well. Making his way down to the ring, making his debut in Ring the Bell Wrestling, it is Zach Quinn.
Yep, and well, let's see if it could be Zach Quinn who could, you know, pick up the major victory tonight, a big debut matchup. And his debut could defeat some of the likes of Eli Drago and move forward in the European title tournament.
It could very well be indeed. And you gotta be thinking here though, Mikey, signing him here definitely has a lot of promise for him here. Thinks he could be a great one here, putting him into the European title tournament already just on his debut.
Yes, and it's a tall order for Zach Quinn, instead of seeing his work for the independents, you know. And that's all hard-hitting individuals. So let's get brutal in the ring. We'll see if you can bring us some mentality here to ring the bell and defeat Eli Drago and move forward in the tournament.
Well, I'm sure Zach will be looking to just that here tonight. We've seen, like I said, what Zach has been able to do before. We're going to see how he does here tonight. I mean, going against, you know, Mr. Five Stars, Eli Drago. I'm sure this is going to be a great match here. Can Zach Quinn find a weakness here in Eli Drago? Jason, who do you have in this one?
I figure I'll have to go, you know, with Mr. Five Stars Eli Drago. Said, you know, I have seen more of him, you know, since he made his debut here in Ring of Bell Wrestling. Eli Drago has been a very impressive superstar. Has picked up monumental wins, has had streaks. Could he be on another win streak to try to go after that European Championship?
Could very well be indeed. As right now though, Eli Drago trying to continue here against Zach Quinn. Dropping down the big knees here. And again!
Yep, using that high flying ability with that agility. Now has Zach
Quinn. A standing Spanish fly!
Very impressive. And Zach Quinn's being prepared for this.
There's always a big kick here. Now trying to continue.
Yeah, now Zach Quinn's going to try to get momentum and offense on his side as he has Eli Drago on the shoulders. An old roundhouse kick.
Yeah, big roundhouse kick here. But oh wait, Zach Quinn able to take him down. But oh wait, now a big knee there from Zach.
And use that sort of striking power, so sort of that brutal offense as you're seeing here. And oh, another knee strike.
Yeah, but now Eli into the corner here. But now just dropping down big boots is Zach Quinn. But oh, wait. Oh, I think Zach thinks he's the best in the world.
Yep, so he seems that way. He looks like he wants to go coast to coast.
Best in the world.
Lord, yeah.
He hits it there. Now maybe is he thinking about going for a cover? No, he's gonna let the Eli Drago up here. And no, but Eli Drago able to bounce back there and get a big close on there, taking Zach Quinn off his feet. And now a big stop there. Now it is Eli Drago looking to do. Big knee strike there. But oh wait, Zach Quinn though, now gonna show off his power here. Has Eli Drago driving the back into the turnbuckle. But oh wait, went for a big kick. Wasn't able to get him. And now here's close on there from Zach.
And now picking Eli Drago up. It was a good plan. Now tries to win. Now Eli Drago hits a big clothesline.
Big clothesline there. Look at that big moonsault from Eli Drago. And well, I mean, you gotta be thinking here, you know, Mikey, putting a man that he just signed against the man that he just traded for together here in the European title tournament. He already spoke great things of Eli Drago. When he heard about the trade that was going to possibly happen, he jumped on it because he said, this is going to be a football reference for you and you won't know it, but look at that big strike there. He said that this is like training for Pat Mahomes. He's training for one of the best, and that's what he truly thinks about Eli Drago as he makes his way over. Right now, though.
Oh, go for a cover. I mean, don't if you know, so after Eli hit, you know, that springboard's forearm strike, he did land awkwardly. It looked like he was in pain, but not sure. Now it's big kick up on the clothesline.
Yeah, big kick up there. But oh wait, Zach Quinn able to continue here, starting to mount a comeback here against Eli Drago. Big kick there. Now what is Zach Quinn thinking of doing? Has Eli Drago cornered here, and there's a big boot.
Oh, Lord GM, booting him right in the face.
Yeah, big boot into the face. Now Zach Quinn going for the cover. Is this going to be enough? Can he put away? No! Only a one.
Just a one count. And Eli Drago look right behind you, Zach Quinn. He's immediately up and has caught him to a standing Spanish fly.
Is now into the cover. Is this going to be it? Two. No! But now Zach Quinn has Eli Drago up. Big punch there. Taking him down. Now going for the cover. Is this going to be enough? Two. No. Eli Drago able to kick out.
They're able to do Zach Quinn. Shows us frustration, but he's just got to keep on the offense. I mean, he knows who he's in the ring with. He knows he's going to take one. That's a better way to the likes of Eli Drago.
Yeah, but look at this monkey foot there from Zach Quinn. Now Zach has Eli Drago up. What is he looking to do?
Oh, has him with the shoulders and another roundhouse kick. Yeah. But look at that, Eli Drago rolls the outside.
And oh, look at this though. Big spinning leg takedown there. Now is Eli Drago looking to do? Is it Spanish fly?
Not yet another one, and now go to the corner.
As always, Eli Drago, what is he looking to do? And a big kick, cutting and knocked out Zach Quinn there.
Cover that tornado in Sakari. Now go for the cover, hook in the leg.
Two, no.
Zach Quinn able to kick out.
Yeah, but now Zach Quinn, what is he looking to do? But oh, was he trying to go for something there? But getting caught with the super kick and the suplex there.
Yeah, straight jacket, German suplex, and now Eli, oh, it's going up top.
And Eli Drago going up high. Look at this!
Oh, double rotation moonsault.
Two, three, and Eli Drago able to pick up the victory.
And well, big with Eli Drago. He moves forward in the European title tournament.
Yeah, he moves forward in the European title tournament. Big win there for Eli Drago. Definitely a great trade there by Michael Lee. But now, Zach Quinn, I'm sure he's going to be looking to go back to the drawing board after that loss in the debut. But no shame in it, though. He lost to Eli Drago. Big win there, though, for Eli. But now, we have another big matchup here. Dylan Bannon is going to be going against Irina Frost.
Yeah, what a matchup. match is going to be a big opportunity for Talonbound, not against a former women's champion.
As well, coming out first, it is Dylan Bannon.
Yeah, see if it could be Dylan Bannon to pick up a major victory over a former women's champion. And see, Dylan Bannon, she does that, would get herself a step closer to try and transfer the World Battlefront Women's Championship.
Yeah. Let's see what Dylan Bannon's going to be able to do here tonight. She has been having the best start to her career, but she's going to be looking to try and turn it all around here tonight, getting the win against the former Women's Champion, Indy Rayner Frost.
Yep. It's a big opportunity for Tim Mann, but you know, against Euro Frost, it's not going to be easy. You know, we see what Euro Frost can do in the ring. You know, it's a former women's champion. So it's a tall order.
Definitely going to be a tall order here for Dylan Bannon. But now, coming down to the ring, she is Euro Frost.
Now, Euro Frost, she wants to try to get back into the title contention. Now let's have a try and get a rematch with Kelly Casey, try and, you know, take the Battlefront Women's Championship, put herself, you know, as back as the top woman.
She's gonna be looking to do just that. I mean, you gotta be thinking though, I mean, Euro Frost, she tried getting a big victory against Christina Jean when she was on Battlefront for number contendership. But now though, Kelly Casey doesn't have a number contender, because Christina, she was traded over to Apex, and she's going to be going against the winner of the Apex tournament. So that definitely opens it back up for Euro Frost, and she can definitely pick up the momentum that she needs. Maybe getting a big victory here tonight against Dylan Bannon could be what she needs here tonight.
Oh yeah, definitely could be exactly what she needs to try to get her stuff back up there into a set to title contention. Try and go after the likes of Kelly Casey, that championship, you know, Dylan Bannon's hungry competitor, wants to put herself in there for top contention.
Yeah, she's definitely going to be one to. I mean, like I said, she hasn't had the best start, but, I mean, getting yourself a win against the former champion, that definitely can move you up in the rankings, and Dylan's going to be looking to do just that here tonight. But right now, though, Euro Frost taking early control of the matchup, but Dylan able to turn it all around.
And Dylan quickly turns it around, and now big takedown. Euro Frost is in trouble.
Yeah, but now look at this though. Fireman's carry there from Euro Frost has her here. Euro looking to try and continue here against Dylan. And eat the feet!
It's eat the feet. Dylan Bannon's in trouble in the other guys, but we see that she can turn things around very quickly. This right to go for a cover, but no, an easy kick out.
Yeah, easy kick out there way too early, not even a one count, but now Dylan driving Euro into the ropes. As long as they're keeping the hold here, I think the ref's going to have to break him up. No, they're going to break him naturally, but a big slap there from Euro Frost. But now with those big boots into the face there again of Dylan Bannon, Euro Frost looking to try and continue here. As now Euro has her here, trying to stomp on her while she's down, but now throwing her head into the canvas.
Brush her head to the canvas, and now a big drop kick into the head.
Yeah, big drop kick there is from Euro Frost. Now Euro has Dylan Bannon up here. It's all taken up and into a big powerbomb there. But now, what is Euro looking to do? But oh wait, Dylan able to roll all the way. Big elbows here. And now, facebuster there. As Dylan Bannon continuing here against Euro Frost. Now Dylan has her in the middle of the ring, big boots down, and just continuing with the stomping.
And just stomping at the back. And now.
The goal is now.
Over the arm, uh-oh. Just trying to bend that booty in ways it should not be bent. And just dropping the knees down.
Yeah, dropping the big knees down is now Dylan. Has her up again. Big boot into the midsection. and just driving the face into the canvas. There is now Dylan has her up yet again. Is now big knee into the midsection and dropping down the boot.
Put it down until Baron's fairly fired up. Yeah. She's got this match well in hand.
Is now Dylan Ben, what is she looking for here? Has her, and again, driving the head into the canvas. As now Dylan looking to go up high. Can she make the distance?
Can she?
Does, but into the knees, but using the momentum to bounce right back up.
Yeah, that was quick thinking from Dylan Ben. Yeah, go for the painful landing knees, it all great. But she just brushed it off, let the adrenaline take control, kept up. Is able to get the match back in her hand. Now has around the first up on the shoulders.
And
backpack stunner.
Yeah, big stunner there. Now, what is he waiting for us? We're going to do as Dylan banding up big boots into the midsection. Now turning around into a hangman face buster there.
Now
what is Dylan Frost going to do? Maybe we're going to go for the cover. Yes, she does. Is this gonna be it? No, only a one.
Just a one count. And Dylan Baron's getting up.
And now they're taking her down again. As always, now Erin Frost, we're gonna try and continue here against Dylan Baron. Has her against the ropes. Now throwing her to the outside, but what's she have in mind?
And what has she got planned? Oh boy! Tapecanello! Well, just throwing caution to her. Almost a bad for you, right? She nearly smashed her face right into the announce table, but just avoided it.
Yeah, just barely avoiding it there. But now you're in a frost. What is she looking to do? Has Dylan banning up? But oh wait, Dylan able to turn all around and tanking her down. Now Dylan has her up.
Drops it down. Widow's peaking now.
No.
Ryan able to kick out until man and cannot believe it.
Yeah, cannot believe it. Oh. And now. Dropping down the boot.
And then just smash the back of her head into the ring. Dylan Baron's feeling in firm control.
As now Dylan taking back firm control of the matchup, throwing the Rain Frost into the corner here. And oh wait, off the ropes and a big jump across body.
He's throwing a whole body into that as a cover. But no, Urena easily kicking out.
Urena easily able to kick out there, but wait, Dylan able to roll away. And a spear!
Oh, yes.
Into the cover!
Yes.
Two! No!
Once again, Urena Frost able to kick out, and Dylan Banner cannot believe it.
Yes, now Dylan trying to go for it here, taking it down. Now, but no, wait, Urena able to roll away. And now has her here. And it's spinning on prettier.
It's that could be all over.
Two. No, Dylan able to kick out, but just barely.
And just barely last split second able to kick out. And now you're in a frost where she got planned.
And what does she plan? Another strike there. It's now. What does she have in mind?
Yeah, had Dylan Baron set up in the corner.
As always, big boot there. And a takedown there from Dylan.
Yeah, hitting that sleeper slam. And now Dylan Baron has her up a shot for kicking the Raider countering. And big Hurricane Rana.
Yeah, huge Hurricane Rana there from. Urena Frost. Urena now going for the cover, middle of the ring. Is this going to be enough? Two, no, Dylan able to kick out.
Able to kick out, and now, oh, it's that kick in the right quarter. Oh, freaking devil to Subprinia!
Hits it! Two, no! But now you're in Frost. Just driving the fist into the face of Dylan. It all is now Azra up here. But oh wait, Dylan able to find a way out of it. Now what's she going for here? Never take down there. Now go for the cover. Is this gonna be it?
One.
No.
Right, Frost, easy kick up from that jumping flyliner, and Dylan Badge is looking frustrated. Foreshadow there.
Yeah. Now but look at this. But no, oh. A rope break.
Yeah, far too close to the ropes.
As always now, but Dylan has her up, GTS, and a suplex, and into the cover of the perfect bridge. Two, no, Urena kicks out.
Hey, Urena first able to kick out the last second, and now it just gets face smashed into the ring. Now Dylan Baron looking to try and end things.
Yeah, trying to end things here. It's all big bad pack there, now go for the cover. Two, three, and Dylan Bannon picks up the victory.
A big time victory for Dylan Bannon following that world, that Widow's Peak. It's a much needed victory for her. She's just got victory over the former women's champion. That's pretty huge for her.
Yeah, definitely a huge victory here for Dylan Bannon over Urena Frost. Well, let's see if Dylan Bannon can definitely ride that momentum and get more wins. But for now, though, we have the final match of the first round of the European Title Tournament. It's Chase Owens going against Elijah Riley. Extreme Rules. Who's going to be going forward in the European Title Tournament?
Yep, it'll be the one going forward. We're about to find out.
Coming down to the ring first, it is Chase Owens.
Yep, well, let's see. It'll be Chase Owens to pick up a victory. Big victory, be moving forward. Instead, he's been picking up major victories recently. This could be another one for him. Of course, it seems so. Whenever he does get a victory, the fans don't like it. Maybe Manchurian particularly likes it, but I don't think Chase Owens much cares.
Yeah, I don't think he much cares. Like we said before, he's definitely been able to use the hatred towards him, been able to turn it around and get major victories. And now, tonight could be a first one that's going to be going towards a title here tonight. We could be moving along in the European Title Tournament, be going against Eli Drago. But let's see if Chase Owens can get that big victory here tonight.
Yeah, so he can get that big victory, but you know, he's got a tough opponent ahead of him. You know, certainly no pushover, but I'm sure that Chase Owens knows that very well. And well, he'll be looking to, you know, take the glory for himself and move forward.
Yeah, he'll be looking to do that. He's been trying and move forward here tonight. I mean, we've seen what Chase has been able to do ever since he got through that win for BWA back in the Super Series. He's been really just a different animal ever since then, been getting a lot of big victories, had some minor losses, but I mean, I think the victories he's had has definitely outnumbered the losses, and now, after a big win last week, Mike Lee definitely saw what he was doing and put him into the European Title Tournament, and let's see how Chase Owens does here tonight.
Yeah, because you know his opponent is, you know, another top tier level athlete. Let's make his way out.
Mm-hmm. As well, coming down to the ring, he is a former Triple Crown champion. It is Elijah Riley.
You gotta think when Elijah Riley's, you know, season started. This season so famous Triple Crown champion, end up losing it, but now who knows, maybe he could end this season as, you know, European champion. And some people may think that's a step down, but I think Elijah Riley would be one of those people now to try and elevate that championship. And let's see what Elijah Wiley can do. Can he move through to next round against Chase Owens?
Can he move through here tonight? Can he get a big win here? Pick up the European Championship. I mean, we've seen what Elijah Wiley's been able to do in the past. And like I said, he is a former Triple Crown champion. I'm sure he will can try and move up those rankings again. But for now, though, I think a European title to end out the season could definitely be very well for Elijah Wiley. Of course, that would mean he would have to win this tournament and defend it at Endgame, something he wasn't able to do before later on, defending the Triple Crown. Granted, first person to ever on their first defense.
Yep. That's very true. Elijah Wiley was, you know, the first success of someone actually, you know, successfully defending the Triple Crown Championship. Of course, that one came within this season of people actually being able to do it, but Elijah Wiley can say he was the first.
And it definitely was the first here. Is now Elijah Wiley, what is he looking to do? Of course, you know, Elijah Wiley, he was also a former European champion. Could very well be, I believe he would be the first time, you know, two-time European champion. Right now, though, what is he looking to do? Threatening Chase while he's on the outside.
I think Chase Owens is going to be much afraid, but Elijah Wiley realizes that 6-1. It's a big pele kick.
Yeah, here's pele kick here. But now, what is he looking to do? Has him up here. And that's attacking the leg here of Chase Owens.
They're just going after it, and now him up. Kick it to Khan, hits a big face buster, Pico breaker, using the knee.
And he's on the knee, there's now Elijah Wiley. The huge palm strikes here to the chest here of Chase Owens. But now, big kick here. But oh wait, has him. And taking Zamble immediately back up is Chase Owens.
And then it's a monumental back fist, and now no hands at us. Sit up, power bomb.
As now is all trying to go for a big stomp there, wasn't able to get him. Super kick there from Chase Owens. Now, what is he looking to do? Is Elijah Wiley able to fight back here? But no, Chase able to continue. But now Chase has him. Neck breaker there.
Time neck breaker, and now good plant.
As always, Chase has him up, and here's power bomb to Elijah Wiley. Now
sit out.
Yeah, massive sit out power bomb trying to continue here. Chase Owens working over on the arm here of Elijah Wiley, but Elijah able to find his way out of it, trying to go for a super kick, but able to sidestep it. There was Chase Owens.
Can sidestep that.
Oh, the pele kick.
Huge, huge pele kick. And now Elijah Wiley has Chase Owens up at all. Kicked him a little like in the knee.
Yeah.
Up suplex.
But now Elijah Wiley going for the cover. Is this going to be enough? No, only a one.
Just look at it. You can see Chase Owens getting up. And yes, Elijah Wiley caught.
Yeah, but look at this. Has him into a sweeper hold here.
Got him in a guillotine choke. It is Elijah Wiley going to tap out.
But no way. Elijah Wiley able to power his way out of it.
Yeah, picked him up and then hit a spine buster to escape that guillotine choke hold. But now
we're going to know Elijah has Chase Owens up here. But no way. Big elbows there. But no way. Now punches to the back. And now
look. Oh, good vicious elbow strikes in. Oh no.
Look at this. Poison
Rana. Oh, God. A huge poison Rana. Good Lord.
Is that Elijah? No.
Chase Owens kicked out at one.
And Chase Owens able to kick out there. Now trying to threaten Elijah Wiley there. But Elijah able to stop him there. But no, wait, out of the way is Chase Owens. Chase has Elijah up into the big cutter. And now Chase maybe looking to get the first weapons here. Trying to get the toys into the matchup. As he gets the kendo stick in.
Uh-oh. Oh, goodness, just working on the back. And the boy just got to town with that kendo stick.
Wow. Yeah, but now Chase Owens has Elijah Riley up.
Just
tossing him down.
Owens with a kendo stick to try to cause more damage now has Elijah Riley.
As always, Chase has him up again and a huge power bomb there. But oh wait, big kick there. And now Elijah able to take Chase to the outside. Oh, he looks like he's going to bring the kendo stick out with him.
Yeah, now he's going to use it as a weapon and just goes to town on Chase Owens. Chase Owens, dodge out the way.
Yeah, but
takes the kendo stick.
And now just swinging away here at Chase. Oh, Chase now again. Just swinging away here on Elijah Riley. This is not looking good for Elijah.
No, it isn't. Jesus just went him down that canvas. But look at this though, Elijah Riley never count out his toughness. Trying to fight back.
Trying to fight back here. But oh, now big DDT.
And of course, the cutouts.
And Elijah going for that candlestick yet again. Oh wait, but Chase able to fight his way out of it and take that candlestick off his hands.
This is Chase Owens is really the master with that kendo stick. And oh god, down the head.
Yeah, now just swinging away as now is Chase Owens. Big boots down. Now has him up.
Oh, tricks him.
On the ramp.
He's like an LED. I mean, I don't think it's tough, but could crack if you're not careful.
Could very well indeed. But now, what is he looking to do? But oh wait. Chase has him up. Side slam there. Now what is Chase Owens looking to do? Has Elijah Riley up and taken down.
Attempt out that back suplex. Gotta fear these two taking quite a lot of punishment. A lot of it also dealt with that kendo stick, but Elijah Riley's definitely been on the worst end of that when it comes to the kendo stick.
Definitely has indeed. But oh, we're gonna still Chase Owens. Has Elijah Riley up. And oh, huge power bomb.
The bomb of his spine there once again hit the kendo stick and Chase Owens once again. Oh, but Elijah Riley.
Oh, drop kick there. And now he's going for the cover. One, two, no.
Chase Owens able to kick out. That could have been a just lost DeGeffer from Elijah Riley. But now he's going to look to grab a weapon of his own. Trying even the odds. Uh-oh.
As always now, what is he looking for here? But no, not able to get it.
No, not able to.
Oh god,
that was close. Nearly hit the sledgehammer.
Yeah, nearly did, but now Chase has Elijah Riley up. Big super kick there. Now.
Dropped him on the sledgehammer.
Now to cover. One, two, three, and Chase Owens able to pick up the victory.
Yeah, picks up the victory. Well, Elijah Riley tried to bring the sledgehammer, and all it did was backfire on him as Chase Owens, the flatliner onto it, picks up the victory.
Yeah, big victory there from Chase Owens over Azrawi. He's going to be moving on in the European title tournament. Big win there from Chase Owens. But I'm also being told he's asking for a microphone here, so let's see what Chase Owens does have to say. Saying, you people used to call me a jobber, so you know what, I started winning when you still weren't happy with me, so you called me a turncoat, all because I knew my worth, and I took the risk to jump to Battlefront to get away from Coach, the worst GM in history. But now look at me, Coach, the man with no potential is now moving up in the European title tournament.
Well, I can't disagree with Chase Owens calling it Coach the worst GM in history.
What do you mean?
you know, the corruption and everything. But let's listen to Chase Owens.
Well, Chase continues saying, I've used this hatred that all of you have towards me. Now it's fueling my big run at the European title. Nothing was handed to me. Everything God was earned, unlike some people. Yes, I had a big win repping VWA. Yes, I jumped ship from Apex to Battlefront. But I'd do it all again to get to be right here to rub it in all your prophetic faces.
Well, Chester's just rubbing it in, but yeah, people have called him various different things. A betrayer, or a turncoat, well, you love to call him a Benedict Arnold. Say everything, he likes to rub it in people's faces.
Yeah, he likes to rub it in people's faces. But well, guys, that is it for the show. Just to say goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fans.
And well, guys, I'm, of course, the main commentator, John Roman, and I will see you guys all this Monday for Apex. See you there.